Now, as we've talked about many of the evacuations and those who have heeded the warnings and the calls from their local officials, there are some who are still keeping an eye on their homes as they heed those warnings and requests. Let's go now to Grant and Ray Lynch. They have a house in Palm Coast, which is here in Florida, about 60 miles south of where I am in Jacksonville, and they are watching from Lake Mary via security cam, and we have some of that video watching with you. Thanks for joining us, and give us an idea of what you're seeing and how you've seen the conditions change over the last several hours.
This is Ray. I'm Grant's father. It's been pretty crazy. Last night we were watching the security camera and really couldn't see anything because there was night vision. But as the day progressed and light came up, we were kind of watching the waves, and I saw them go over the dune, and I told my wife, just watch. And we couldn't believe what we saw. It was, I mean, it just started coming, and then when it hit the glass windows, I thought the glass would shatter because it went up to the top of the glass.
There was rocks coming from the beach and hitting the windows. It was crazy.
Wow, and I'm watching some of this video with you. As you're watching it, what's going through your mind?
I've never seen anything like it. I've never seen the water even get that far to the house. I mean, it's 150 feet away from our house to the dunes. And then once you go from the dunes to the ocean, it's about another 200 feet. So the waves had to be in 10 plus waves to get to our house.
Well, we've heard from our meteorologist that the storm surge along the Jacksonville beaches, it's 5 to 9 feet, probably something similar down south, 60 miles from where we are there along Palm Coast. But are you speaking with your neighbors? What are you hearing from them? Did any of them stay behind?
No, nobody stayed behind. As you can see now on the TV, that's the back of the house when we boarded it up and put about 50 sandbags in front of those glass doors. And that's a picture of how high the dune is from the water if you're out in the ocean. So it came up pretty high. I'd be surprised if it wasn't over 15 to 20 feet.
And those sandbags were 60 to 80 pounds, and that wave just moved them like they weren't even there.
You know, Grant, Ray, as we're watching this video, it seems like an obvious decision to evacuate when you're seeing the reason that officials asked so many to leave. But before we saw the storm come and we saw this damage, why did you make the decision to leave? The decision that, frankly, so many did not.
We really wanted to stay. We almost turned back to go back to the house because we had some valuables we really wanted to remove, because we didn't think the storm was going to be as bad as it was. But as predictions came out, I'm like, we need to go back. And by that time, the bridges had already closed.
All right, Grant and Ray Lynch, we're watching the security camera footage of their home there in Palm Coast, again, 60 miles south of where I am here in Jacksonville. It's, you're seeing the water lap up against their house, a significant surge there of what has been, from officials, the major concern from the start of this storm. We thank you both for sharing that video and your story with us. But again, an example of why officials for days have asked people